Is facial recognition, or fingerprint ID, safe? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. My phone lets me use my face or my fingerprint to sign in. Is that safe? Couldn't a hacker steal that information, especially if it's uploaded to the cloud somewhere? This is a very complex and very controversial issue for a variety of reasons, and I'm not going to get into the political ramifications of surveillance states and facial recognition and all that kind of stuff, because there's more to it than biometrics, which is basically a blanket term for storing something about your face or something about your fingers that allows them to confirm it's the same face or it's the same finger. I'm not going to claim to be an expert by any stretch. I am not. But I do have, as is often the case, some opinions and some semi-knowledgeable thoughts on exactly what's going on. To give you a bottom line on it, I use facial recognition and fingerprint ID on my devices. So, storing your face. There's a misconception, I think, that when you set up facial recognition, that somehow a photo of you is stored and uploaded to the cloud or done something that allows them to then say, okay, fine, we'll take another picture of you at the time you're looking to identify yourself, compare it to the original photo, and see if it's still you. As I understand it, that's not how it works. It actually works a lot more like passwords. So, yes, when you set up facial recognition, a photograph is taken, but they don't store the photograph. What they do is analyze the photograph for, I'll just call it landmarks. There are a number of other terms that might be associated with it, but it's basically, you know, where on your face is your nose relative to your eyeballs and your lips and all those kinds of things. It's like I said, it's way more complicated than that, but that's kind of sort of the abstraction that ends up getting used. That information, not your photograph, but the map of landmarks, is then hashed. By that I mean, rather than storing the actual information about those landmarks, the data is probably represented in some well-understood digital form that's then hashed. It's a one-way hash, which means that there's a number that's generated from this information. But it's a one-way number. It's that number that gets stored somewhere in the cloud or on your device or who knows. The bottom line, though, is that that number, even if it falls into somebody else's hands, tells them nothing about your face. It tells them nothing about the landmarks, and it is certainly not your photograph. Instead, the next time you try to use your face to identify yourself on your device, it goes through those same machinations. It takes a look at your picture, it generates a map of those landmarks, it generates a hash from that map, and then compares that hash to the hash that's been stored previously, and if they match, must be the same face. If they don't match, well, let's keep trying, right? We'll give it a few tries. Most facial recognition, I'm sure, runs through several iterations because, as we all know, faces change, but they change in predictable ways. I want to be clear. It's not like they're storing exact information. Depending on which direction you're looking, whether you're looking up and down, how much you've aged, any of those kinds of things can all affect the minute details of your face. The algorithms that they're using to generate this map somehow take that into account. I don't know how, but they do. The bottom line then is that information, once they take all that fuzziness into account, is still something that they can hash or do something hash-like that allows them to have this one-way information that cannot be reverse engineered into the information about your face, but can be used to determine that the same information has been provided twice. Once when you set up facial recognition, and once again later when you try to authenticate using facial recognition. My understanding is that the same technique works for fingerprints as well. They look at landmarks, these swirls and whorls, I think they call them, of your actual fingerprint. They're not storing a picture necessarily, but they're actually doing an analysis of how things laid out. Now, to be clear, sometimes they do take pictures. Sometimes they do store photographs. The scenario that I have is that on a recent overseas trip, when I returned, one of the things I had to do going through customs was to have their camera take a picture of my face. I was expecting then to have to provide my passport or another form of ID or something. Nope, didn't have to do any of that. By the time I walked up to the customs agent, he had my information on screen based only on the picture that they had just taken as I returned. There are agencies, typically government agencies, that actually do store your photograph. But that's not necessarily the same as what's happening when we're using facial recognition and fingerprint ID to sign into your devices. Now, there's a really interesting observation here that I'm not sure necessarily what to make of. To begin with, I have to throw out the usual caveat. I am not a lawyer. This is not legal advice. If you actually care about this deeply, talk to an attorney. But in the United States, I believe it is not required that you provide a password, that you tell them your password. I believe it falls into self-incrimination or something along those lines. The bottom line, though, is that they can't force you to tell them your password. However, no such limitation exists on things like faces and fingerprints. So if you have stuff on a device that's locked and it matters to you that the government, maybe crossing a border, could force you to touch the device with your finger or look at the device to unlock it with Face ID, don't use those. Use a password instead. Again, I don't know how much to make of this. I don't know how important this really is. Certainly for the average consumer, it's not something I am concerned about. I traveled with my phone with fingerprint ID just fine. But again, if you are in a situation where you are someone who is for whom this kind of thing might matter, make sure you're choosing the correct form of identification and authentication on your device, understanding the ramifications of some of those choices. Now, you're asked, is it safe? No. There is no such thing as safe. And that's true for this scenario. That's true for almost any scenario when it comes to computer security and personal security. There is no such thing as safe. There is only safer or less safe. You can be more or less safe. By making the right choices for your security, what I advocate you do is work towards making yourself more safe. That means using the right kind of security for your specific scenario, understanding your needs, your tolerance for risk, and your willingness to jump through whatever hoops are necessary to authenticate when you need to. But you have to understand that there is no such thing as perfection. There is no such thing as absolute safety. It's something to strive for, but it's also something you and I will never reach. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/153415. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.